mic gain, mic plug, excuse me, external speaker jack or headphones. The top panel of the radio, all your switches. Let's see, we have AM, FM, PA, dimmer, three positions, high, medium, and low. Your noise blankers, Roger beep, and this is something kind of unusual, channel 19 switch. Electronic band changing, TXRX light, antenna warning light, and of course your channel display. Below that, channel knob, echo and time, variable talkback and variable power, volume and squelch, and last of course the big nice easy to read meter. Now what we're going to do from here is we're going to go ahead and take a look at the inside of the board. So give me just a minute and we'll be right back. One of the other features, I don't know how well this will show up, but this is below this green board, the one below it is a channel selector. It's also where you convert the radio. That's a new interesting circuit board there. We'll take a look at the front. Okay, as you can see, this board is quite a bit bigger, protrudes out. Of course, here's our meter, which is quite large. And then our other plug and accessory jacks over here. Just mic plug and all that stuff. Nothing spectacular there. I'll give you a kind of a rundown of the radio on the inside. Everything else looks fairly standard. Okay, we're back. We've got it converted. Let's see what kind of dead keys this thing set at from the factory. Okay, this is going to be untouched, just what the factory set it at. RF power is all the way down. Let's take a look at our meter. Half a watt on low. Let's turn it all the way up. 10.9, 11 watts high. So that's where we're at. Let's see what kind of swing we get. All right, so we're going to start this on the low power setting. And let's go back up. Put this on peak. Zoom in. Hello, audio test. Hello, 1, 2, 3. Well, we got a whole 3.72 watts with the RF power down on low. Not very impressive. Let's go to high. Hello, audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Audio test, hello, 1, 2, test. 55.9. Well, that's something we can work with. Well, needless to say, it's going to take a little bit of work, but let's see what happens. I'm going to go through and tune this radio, get everything done the way that I normally do it, and let's see what happens when we're done. Be right back. Okay, we're back. What we've done now is we've got it tuned up, got the dead key set, about 1.7 watts on low. We had to turn it up to about 15 watts on high. So we got her back on low. What I want to do is let's see what kind of wattage we get now. Hello, audio 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Audio test, 1, 2. 67.4 on low. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 67.4 on high. Well, folks, that pretty well is what this particular radio does. And I said around 70 watts, 67.4, that's almost 67 and a half on the LP100A. So I'm sure on any dozy or most other meters, we'd see 70 watts easy. So we've got the transmit pretty well done on our tune. Now what I want to do is go through and see how good the receive is on it as it is, and then we're going to align it if it needs to be, and we'll see how much of an improvement we get. Be right back in just a minute. All right, we're back. You can hear the tone running in the background. This is a 30 microvolt signal, 30 watts AM modulation on channel 20. You can see where our S meter reading is, which is not very good, by the way. So we're going to go in here. We're going to just do, we're going to do one quick adjustment. Oh, look at that. Look at that come right up. That brought it up tremendously. About right there. Whoa. Well, just with a quick adjustment, you can see that the receive was pretty far out of alignment. Now I'm going to go through and I'm not going to do this on camera because it's going to take me a few minutes, but I'm going to go through and go ahead and do the final alignment, and I'll be back and we'll go over some of the other features of the radio. Give me just a few minutes. Okay, I don't know how this is going to look, but we've got half the lights out here. I want to go through these colors. That's what everybody's excited about. So there's green. There's red. There's orange. There's purple. There's blue. There's violet, I guess. Well, there's blue. And back to green. This thing's got a lot of colors. I'll go over them again. Red, orange, purple, some sort of blue, violet, dark blue. Now, with that being said, let's, as we increase the dimmer, that's on the medium position, and that's on the bright position. So let's go over with it on bright. Blue. Oh, check that green out. Green, red, that'll light you up. Orange, violet, blue, white, back to blue, green, red, real green, I guess. It's hard for me to tell these colors. That's purple. That's a blue, and that's white. Now that white is kind of cool. I don't know how well the camera's picking it up, but the white really is kind of a cool color. And blue. Green's not bad either. So we're going to dim this into our second position. That's medium. And that's low. And as you can see on the low position, these lights are very, very dim. There's the red, purple, violet, or whatever it is. That's kind of a bluish green. This is white. And I didn't even recognize it in the low position, but that's white. That's on the medium position in white. And that's on the high position in white. And boy, as you can see, it's white. Alright, so let's go back to, I like green, so let's go to green. The other thing that we want to look at here is the band changing. And that's done by this button. And as you can see, an LED displays next to the channel, which this is on D band, E band, F, A, B, C, and D. E, F, back to A. So D band is normal 40. We have a channel 19 switch, which as I flip that up, you notice it takes you straight to 19 and the display shows 19. Roger beep, noise blanker, your dimmer, of course AM, FM, PA. Back to our big meter, which also changes color, by the way, red, amber, purple. Purple's good looking too. Blue, white, dark blue, back to green. And then back over here, as I said before, we have our mic RF gain, external speaker plug or headphone set, and our front mounted mic jack. Well guys, this is all we're going to cover on this today. We aligned the radio. We know the radio didn't come from the factory very well aligned. We know the radio didn't come from the factory very well tuned. Took a little work to get everything up, but the radio came up really well. It's got all the features. Good looking radio. I like that big meter. Seems like a pretty fair radio. We're getting close to 70 watts out of it, so it just might be a keeper. This is the first one I've done. I wanted you to see the video of it first, so hopefully this will give you a little heads up on the new radio out from Connex. This is the Connex 3400 HP. I want to thank all you guys for watching. Visit me on the web at www.customcbradios.com. This is CB Repairman. Until we do another video for you folks, have a great day.